Good evening. It worked. The biggest reward in Queensland's history has led to the capture of our most wanted man, with hope there'll be justice for Toyah Cordingley.
Her accused killer is tonight in an Indian jail cell. A $1 million incentive for information flushed out the fugitive in the country's capital.
A major stride on a long, slow march to justice.
The suspect in Toyah Cordingley's murder has been arrested in India.
Toyah's family waited 4 years for those words.
It was never a question of if, only when this day would come.
It came relatively quickly after police put out the biggest reward in Queensland history for information leading to Rajwinder Singh's arrest in India. In a country of 1 billion people with 1 million reasons, he only lasted 23 days in hiding.
Police received information on the whereabouts of the individual, and today he was arrested by Indian law enforcement in New Delhi.
Singh will face court in India before being extradited to Australia to face a murder charge for a crime that disturbed the nation. The only suspect in the horrific random killing of a 24-year-old walking her dog on a secluded beach north of Cairns. At the fruit markets where Toyah shopped during what would be her final hours, relief.
I think it's the best news ever, because he comes from Innisfail, where I come from, and I'm so happy that he's finally been caught and he's going to be brought to justice.
They got him. Oh, about bloody time too, but no, that's fantastic. I was starting to lose hope.
For Toyah, October 21, 2018 was just a normal Sunday until she vanished. Her father discovered her body in a shallow beach grave the next day. 48 hours after her murder, Rajwinder Singh flew to India. Fast forward 2.5 years, an extradition request goes out for his arrest. Earlier this month, after 18 months officially as a wanted man, a $1 million reward was offered.
Australian authorities were at the mercy of the Indian legal process, which moved painfully slowly. That extradition order was finally signed last month, meaning police could move in and get their man.
The man was believed to be avoiding apprehension in the Punjab region in India since travelling to the country.
The result came overseas, but the work began in the far north. At first, the case was baffling. Once family and friends were cleared as suspects, detectives were left with little to work off. Day and night, they began meticulously going through CCTV, watching every vehicle in the area. What they were looking for was unclear, but one officer found it. On a hunch, he raised the name of a man who would become the key suspect.
This will go down as another one of those famous police homicide investigations.
They've been relentless. They never gave up. And today, they've made a significant step towards delivering justice.
Elation at a breakthrough, tempered by thoughts for those whose grief has been as public as the search for a killer.
For the family, I know it would be bittersweet as well.
Toyah would have been 28 now. She'd been working in retail, volunteering at an animal shelter, and never had the chance to write her next chapter. Singh's begins now with court.
Now, Toyah's mother has told 7 News these developments has come as a total shock. I mean, she'd waited so long for an arrest, and now that it's finally here, it's going to take a little while, she said, for it all to sink in and to process it. Of course, the arrest only happened just hours ago, and police are yet to confirm whether the tip-off they got is what led to the breakthrough. But the commissioner did say today, if it did, she'll happily sign the cheque herself.
Thank you, Steve. Let's go to Jordan Bissell now. Jordan, when is Singh expected to arrive back in Australia?
Well, Max, as we just heard, there needs to be an extradition hearing in India, and then Singh will be taken back to Queensland by the police who've been working on the case. They've since travelled over to India to bring him home and to justice. Today certainly is a day hard fought for and won by the Far North community.
Simply, her name was enough. Spreading awareness of a fight for justice, the copy shop has pressed print on 38,000 Toyah bumper stickers. The community will never give up was the Cairns commitment. Finally, persistence paid off.
I was shocked to hear it because I wasn't expecting it so soon, but ecstatic that it's happened.
Toyah became the girl with the sunflower.